message to all you fucking niggas.
With the whack ass dick.
With the whack ass dick. We fake it, cool.
That body don't even count, baby.
Thank you. Next. Thank you. Next. Thank you. Next. I'm so fucking grateful for my ex. Thank you.
Welcome back to the Girl Cave. I'm Kiara.
What's up? It's Justice.
And we have guys.
I'm a pro.
I'm pretty.
You guys, so we're going to get a little deep and a little raw, okay?
Deep and raw. Ooh.
Ooh. Wait a minute, pee-pee.
Deep and raw.
Wait a
minute.
Pee-pee. I love pee-pee.
You love that name for her? This is a message to all of the guys out there that feel like they be doing something but really don't be doing nothing when it comes to sexual encounters.
It's all cap. God damn it. It's all of it. All of it.
We are moaning for your self-esteem.
Exactly.
We gotta let y'all know. It's about time. In the cave, the Girl Cave is gonna bring it to you.
I think you guys should start because I personally have not had any like bad dick.
Same.
So, ladies, pee-pee, juju.
I mean,
why we sound like some Powerpuff Girls?
Because we are. We are. I'm a Powerpuff. bad penis. Like, I'm just saying, like, in reference to you could have lived without that. Like, or to the guys that I've only had sex with one time. Like.
Yeah, like, knew I wasn't coming back for seconds. In the middle of that shit. Like,
damn.
Like, we just now getting into it a good 5 minutes in. And I'm like, I can't wait for this shit to be over because I swear to God I'm blocking you out of this.
So what is bad about it? Is the dick small? Is he not hitting it right? Explain what was bad.
Well, yeah, what was bad? Like, what about the sex made it bad?
Was it short? Did he nut too quick? The pussy might be too good.
Can I tell my story?
Go ahead.
Okay.
Yeah, please.
Okay. So, y'all, long story short, we're going to give y'all a little preface, right? Long story short, so this fine ass nigga working in the Apple store, right? Like, I shoot my shot, boom, what's your number? You got kids? Like, nah. Well, I asked if you got kids first, and then what's your number, obviously, because I'm going to get that number if you had kids. Anyways, so, bro, like, we, like, heavy macking, like, you know, we texting, we FaceTiming, our schedules aren't really adding up, but, like, at this point, I'm like, you know how when you see a nigga that's just mad fine and mad chill, you're just determined to have them. Like, you don't, like, it's just like, nah, this shit gonna work. Like, I don't give a fuck what you talking about.
Yeah,
this
definitely. Work.
Yeah. So, we end up kicking it. Vibes are great. Like, sexual attraction or, like, sexual tension, I guess. It's like, you know, like, he's saying a little slick shit. I'm saying a little slick shit. I'm like, okay, bet. Like, you know, we on the same page, whatever, whatever. Woo. Anyways, he ends up coming over one night. By this time, we probably, like, kicked it in person 3 times. Like, we've been texting and talking, like, mad long. So, I'm like, I'm ready. Like, I'm fucking ready. Mind you, I done cut off all my hoes prior. That's another story we're going to tell later. Anyways, so, invite him over after work. He gets over. He probably gets there around, like, 10:30. Like, he got off at, like, 9-something. So, yeah, he probably got to the house around 10:30. So, you know, we smoke. I'm drinking wine. He doesn't drink. So, like, mind you, I'm, like, a fucking, like, tiger on the prowl at this point. Like, it's late. I've been drinking wine. We done got high. Like, the lights is dim in this bitch. I'm like, nigga, like, it's on, right? So, we low-key end up falling asleep. We wake back up. We smoke again. And at this point, I'm like, okay, either I'm going to go to sleep or we finna get into it. So, what's up? We start talking about it. We talking about nudes. We're showing each other nudes. I'm like, I need to see that in person. Boom. Bet. He's like, you trying to see it now? I'm like, yes. We go downstairs. We get into it. So, we're, like, kissing and, like, rubbing on each other and shit. Like, he takes his pants off. And, like, he's, like, you know, we kissing on each other. He's, like, you know, sucking on my titties. And, like, just all that. And then he, like, backs up. And he's, like, you know, stroking his dick. He's, like, so, shit, you want to give me some head? And literally, like, it's, like, record scratch. Like, like, and, bro.
No facts.
And it's just, like, so this is where, like, it's like a fork in the road, and I can tell I'm going this way, he's going this way, right? I'm not like, I want to talk about it as bitch. Like, it's just like, let's just do it, bro. Like, let's just do it. Like, you could have easily given me head. You could have easily, like, you know, we could have got there, but you just fucking ruined it by shit. You
asking. Give me some.
Yeah, you know,
I even like, niggas ask. Like, just let me do that shit on my leisure.
Exactly.
And my nigga, don't ask me.
Or if you, I'm not gonna do it, you do it.
Right. You put your right. You gonna give me some head? The fuck?
So this is what gets me. I'm like, no. He's like, I mean, why not? I'm like, cause I don't want to. Like,
well,
he's like, I'm saying no. That's how I get right. Nigga, that's how you get right. I don't give a fuck about none of that. Like, I'm like, so what you trying to do? We can reschedule or like, because I'm not. But mind you, when I'm high, like I be in my head, so I'm like easily blown. Like when I like smoke, like it's like the shit's like a light switch, shit crazy. So anyways, he's like, nah, we gonna figure it out, we gonna make it work. I'm like, okay, whatever. So we kissing and shit, we like sucking on each other, necks and nipples and whatever the fuck. So bro. Finally, he ends up getting it up, and then he gets up to go, like, fucking 15 minutes later, 18 minutes later, after foreplay, he finally gets up, he goes to put on a condom, the shit goes back fucking soft, and I'm just like,
what?
Literally, it was so fucking awkward in the room, bro, because he's trying to, like, get it up so he can slide the condom on all the way, and I'm literally sitting in the bed ass naked, like,
like, what's up?
Like, so what's up, bro? Anyways, long story short, he ends up flipping me over. Like, we foreplay, he flipped me over, he's sixing in, it gets hard. Like, we fuck for all of 6 minutes, and then he comes. What did I do? I hopped up, I went to the bathroom, I grabbed a shower, like, a towel for my shower, and I looked at him, and I was just like, so, what you gonna do? Like,
no, period, because after that.
Period, like,
because after all of that.
And have we talked since? No, we have not. Has he tried? Yes, he has. Am I going for it? No, ma'am.
No, I'm not.
And that's just that.
That's crazy.
So what if your pussy was just too good after all the bullshit?
Okay, yeah. So that's okay, what,
so
like,
the beginning was bullshit. He answered.
Was bullshit. So what makes bad dick? Bad dick. One, I've never had sex with a nigga who like couldn't just get it up off the thought or like the sight of like,
period.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, so the fact that you need heads to even get hard,
right.
Whoa, look, no. And then two, I'm also used to niggas who like, before we even hit the bedroom good, like, nigga, you ripping my clothes off, like trying to eat my shit from
you
the back,
ready,
you know? And you act like, you know, you just too like chill, like you gonna give me some head. No, I'm not. Like, are you gonna give me some head? Like,
right, like
I feel like our sexual chemistry was just off. If you're yeah. into one thing and somebody else is into another and it's not like, you know, then it's just yeah. But he was just so fucking fine and I just wanted it to work so bad. But by the end of it, like I was like, bruh, I'm gonna say that. We're gonna get that body.
That's bad dick. A body that you felt like you could have just saved or kept. Let's even get into the fact of how females be like acting like they enjoying the dick, really don't be enjoying the dick.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Like
you can't hit it from one area. You gotta switch it up. You can't just hit it from the front. You gotta switch to the side, the back, the other side, the rabbit leg, I mean, the frog leg. I just gotta get on
the
front.
The lunge.
Yeah, you gotta do all that.
The lunge. Be in tune for real. Like, be in tune. Like, I mean, girls are gonna react. Like, girls are gonna react because obviously we're getting penetrated. But,
yeah.
Like, it's just like be in tune, you know?
But that's the problem. Like, guys, like, a lot of guys just be fucking just the fuck. Like, I mean, like, I know, like, if y'all just met and y'all agree that this is all we're doing, we're just having sex, then that's one thing. But it's like, you have to be like, sex is like sacred, kind of. Like,
it
you
is.
Have to be like, you have to be in flowing with that person for it to be good and for it
you're
to just like work with you
and
no,
sharing
yes.
spirit. So
yes.
don't be fucking these niggas with these demons out here, too.
Yeah.
Don't be fucking these toxic ass niggas.
Also, at the same time, though, right? I read this tweet that was like, women are always complaining about having bad sex, but they don't realize that men work for their nuts, so what are they doing? And honestly, bro, I know a lot of women who just lay down and feel like it's just supposed to work. You know, like, they're supposed to be coming just because they lay in there.
Yeah.
And a lot of women don't know how to do their part during sex to make it feel good. You know what I'm saying? Like, sometimes, like, while he's stroking, you gotta, like, get your own groove to make sure he's hitting it right. Or, like, you know, you gotta, like, shift. You know, you just gotta, like, make sure, like, y'all know what's going on. It's definitely worth discussing. Like, don't let these
yeah.
niggas be out here fucking you, thinking they putting it down, and they not.
Yeah. That's what we talked about, masturbation. Because that shit is important.
Yeah.
Like, that shit is important. If you don't know how to work your own body, how you gonna expect for somebody else to work your body? Yeah.
Yeah. And the confidence that it builds.
Right. Yeah. Like,
yeah. It's like, you know, sexual confidence
that it builds is like, it's crazy.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Back in the day, when nigga was fucking, like, we was fucking, like, it just was what it was. Mm-hmm. But now, it's like a way, like, this ain't working for me. Or it's like, ooh, keep doing that.
So, no.
Exactly. Yeah. That's exactly what it is.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it is.
Hell yeah.
Since, have you had bad sex?
I've definitely had sex that I just felt like, I wish I just would never done that. Like, I could have saved that.
Yeah.
Period. Bad, I'm not gonna say, like, it was bad. Like, you know, but I just wish that it wouldn't have happened.
Yeah.
Really?
What you said that I'm
master painting with that?
Them lips.
Oh my god.
Park them lips! Turn on me some porn, okay?
Bitch, we gonna be over there. How? How you all
on you hoes? I'm going in the closet, don't knock.
Oh my god, man.
You should look
How you gonna do that one?
You know what I'm doing in the closet.
Oh my damn.
Sex can't be selfish. Like, a guy can't go into sex and just, like, be thinking about his nut and not thinking about your nut.
Yeah. And vice versa. Because, but, isn't it, okay, wait, no. Dead ass, bro. Isn't that so crazy how, like, think about, like, the stigma or just, like, the idea of sex and, like, when it comes to, like, us getting ours, right? It's like that, oh, I still fuck, though. Oh, you still let me be.
Right.
It's just like a, you know, like, when you go into it, it's like a, that power move shit, like that, oh, I'm gonna get mine regardless, like, thing. And women are like a, like, yeah, I want us all to enjoy this. I want us both to enjoy this. Like, I hope he feels great. I hope I feel great. You know, like, that shit's so wild. Like, we go into it, like, thinking, like, oh, I'm gonna make this nigga nut, you know? Like,
right.
And niggas go, like, in, like,
I feel like now that our minds have changed, only because, like, more women have come more receptive towards, like, masturbation and, like, pleasing their own selves.
Yeah.
So.
Well, but I will say, nigga, you giving me head, okay? You're giving me it.
Period.
On both sexes, male and female. Yeah. If it's your first time, you just need to watch something to get you a little practice. So you just won't go out there and just be like,
giving mediocre shit.
Cold turkey,
yeah, like, and then, like, a nigga gonna talk about you because your head, you done bit his dick. You know what I'm saying? Because
they gonna tell their friends.
Definitely gonna tell their friends.
So, you
gonna tell our friends.
Period. We're gonna let them know. Not him.
So how, like, why do we go to our friends after something like that? Why don't we say that to? Why don't we tell the guy, oh, your dick was bad, or oh,
I don't want to harm a nigga's self esteem because a nigga could think that his went hard, right?
Okay, and he's like, no, you didn't,
or just about hurting someone's feelings. Yeah. I'm not a hurt a person's feelings type.
You think that that would hurt their feelings of anything?
It would hurt my feelings
if it's your boyfriend.
Well, yeah, it depends. If you're in a relationship with a person, then that's different. First of all, I can't be in a relationship
with you.
Yeah,
that's completely different. That's completely different if you guys are, like, in a relationship.
Yeah.
And you guys been fucking, like, on and off a little
bit. I'm going to tell my nigga. If my nigga got bad anything, I'm going to let him know, like, no, baby, like, I'm going to have to figure out how I'm going to say it. But as far as,
but
in, like,
casual sex type shit, no.
Yeah, like, I could just choose the option, like, okay, I'm not finna go do that again, you know?
It's one thing to, like, have sex with somebody and then, like, not do it again, because I feel like you pretty much get the point. But if this is, like, if something goes wrong, or, like, if, I don't know, if somebody just do something that you're not feeling, like, yeah, then you, I don't want to say you're obligated to, but it's just, like, if that's somebody you feel like you may potentially have sex with again, then you have to.
Definitely,
like, you owe it to yourself, if anything.
Right.
Like,
that's true.
Yeah.
That's true.
Like, I'm not gonna be playing with you.
But, yeah, like, I feel like, yeah, it would hurt someone's feelings if you just let them know. Like, I mean, also, it depends on how you say it. But you have to be really close with that person to just come to them and let them know, like, listen, this wasn't that great, you know?
Yeah. And you kind of have to, like, take yourself out of your feelings about it, too, because it's just, like, I mean, every, like, physical experience you had, like, is it gonna be, like, up to par for every person you come across? You
That's
know,
true.
Like, it's gonna be different. You're gonna learn new shit. Yeah. Like, you know, like, that just is what it is. Fair. I had a nigga tell me, like, well, the circumstance called for it, but I've had, like, a guy tell me, like, okay, yeah, like, we're gonna work on, like, your head. And I was like, okay, nigga. Like, okay, like, you know?
Right. Or even if you're trying to check somebody, your shit ain't up to par either.
Right.
Like, you can't be doing
that. No.
You can't be a pillow pin, like, a pillow princess.
Right. Yeah. Trying to tell a nigga that his dick ain't good. No, that's not gonna happen.
Yeah. No facts.
And you can barely arch it, let alone, like, anything else, yeah. You know?
No facts.
Yeah.
Those knees gotta burn, sis.
It's level, sis.
Those calves and those hip flexors gotta. Yes. Look, you gotta get on the.
Those knees gotta burn, baby.
Those calves.
When those knees burning, right. You gotta stay in there for a good little second or so.
Those thighs and then those hamstrings. You change.
If them edges are still intact, you ain't doing nothing.
You ain't doing enough.
Period. Don't
play
too much.
Right.
Okay.
Girl
Cave,
freak the fuck out.
The girl Cave is real freaked out this week, you guys.
We real freaky. Because of Freak Me. Freak Me just passed.
Freak Me condition. In honor of Freak Me.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Period.
But it's so mad.
Thank you guys so much for watching the Girl Cave this week. PP, Juju, Bree Bree, and Kiki is motherfucking out.
Gay shit. Ain't no lame shit.
Gay shit. Absolutely no lame shit.
No lame.
Period.